This video is going to be about rational expressions and restricted values. And once you understand what the words mean, it's really pretty easy stuff. So a rational expression is basically just a fraction, but it's an algebraic fraction. In other words, it can have x's or y's, it can have variables in it. So 5 over x is a rational expression. Now, a restricted value is a value that x could not have. And the reason x cannot have some values is, you remember one of the basic rules about fractions is you can't have a zero as the denominator, because you can't divide by zero in math. So looking at this, 5 over x, what we know is that x could be any number except for zero, because if x equaled zero, then this would not be a valid fraction. So we can just write x does not equal zero. So zero is a restricted value for x. Let's look at another one. Here I've got 3x plus 5 over x plus 2. Now, I don't care about the numerator. It doesn't matter what the numerator is. What I want to make sure is that this denominator does not equal zero. So I can either do it mentally. You might be able to figure that out. But if it gets too hard, all you have to do is make yourself an equation, right? X plus 2. In other words, write the denominator and write equals zero, and then solve this. So solving it, we'll subtract 2 from both sides, and we get x equals negative 2. In other words, negative 2 is the number that would make x plus 2 equal 0. So we want to write x does not equal negative 2. That's the restricted value for x. Here are a few more examples. Okay, I've got x minus 4 equals 5x. And remember, I don't care about the numerator. I just want to make sure the denominator cannot be 0. So I'll write 5x equals 0, dividing both sides by 5. I'm going to get x equals, well, 0 divided by 5 is 0. So once again, x cannot equal 0. Here's a slightly more interesting one. 3x plus 2, which I don't care about, I just care about the denominator, over x squared plus 7x plus 6. So let's take this denominator and make an equation where it equals 0. X squared plus 7x plus 6 equals 0. Well, this is a quadratic equation, so I'm going to factor this. I'll put in my parentheses, and since it's x squared, I know I'll have an x and an x over here. Both my signs are positive, so I'm dealing with positive signs. And I want to find the factors of 6 that add up to 7. So 6 is either 1 times 6 or 2 times 3, and 1 times 6 sounds good because 1 plus 6 equals 7. And now what I'm going to do is solve for x for both of these possibilities, the x plus 1 and the x plus 6. So x plus 1 equals 0, and x plus 6 equals 0. Subtract 1 from both sides over here, and I'll get x equals negative 1. Over here, I'll subtract 6 from both sides. I'll get x equals negative 6. So remember, these are the values that x cannot be. In other words, x does not equal negative 1 or negative 6. So this is good practice for you for factoring. Let's do another one. X plus 4 over 4x squared minus 25. I want to find out what could make this denominator equal to 0. So let's see. 4x squared minus 25 equals 0. It's a quadratic equation. There's no middle term. So let me think. There's no middle term. I've got a negative sign. between my two terms. And my first term, 4x squared, is a perfect square. And my second term, the 25, is a perfect square. So it looks like I've got the difference of two perfect squares. So I'll take the square root of 4x squared. That will give me a 2x and a 2x. The square root of 25 is 5. So I'll have a plus 5 and a minus 5. You remember these. And then I'll just solve each one of these. So I'm going to have 2x plus 5 equals 0 and 2x minus 5 equals 0. So subtract 5 and I'm going to get 2x equals negative 5. Then I divide by 2 and I get x equals negative 5 halves. And over here, I'll add 5 to both sides. And I'm going to have 2x equals 5. Divide both sides by 2. And I'll get x equals 5 halves. So that means that x does not equal, cannot equal, negative 5 halves or 5 halves. Okay, so that's basically it. Remember, the basic process is this. You look at your rational expression or your fraction. Don't worry about the numerator. You're looking at the denominator and you want to see what could make the denominator equal to zero. So you take the denominator and you write an equation where the denominator equals zero. Then you solve the equation and then whatever values you get are going to be the values that x cannot equal. They are the restricted values. And that's all there is to it. See you next time.